Do you know what was discovered 100 years ago but is still as mind-blowing as it was back then? Cosmic rays. First of all, cosmic ray is a bit of a misnomer because even though they are cosmic, they are not rays, like gamma rays are. No, they are particles, not even full atoms, particles. They are mostly protons, ordinary protons traveling through space. But the reason they are so cool and different is because, unlike normal atoms that just chill around, these guys are in a hurry. And when I say that, I mean it. A lot of them are traveling at 1/3 or even 1/2 the speed of light, and even faster than that. It is our rule of nature that the faster something goes, the more kinetic energy it has. But when we talk about speeds on this level, it's a completely different ballgame. One proton weighs this much, and who knows how many millions and billions of them it takes to make up this tennis ball. So proton is really, really lightweight. On October 15, 1991, scientists were baffled and shocked when they discovered a cosmic ray traveling at, okay, 99.999999999999999999999951% of the speed of light. Let me explain just how fast that is. If a beam of light at that proton were to have a drag race from here to the end of our galaxy, the proton would lose by just about this much. It's that fast. But it doesn't stop there. Since it moved that fast, that single proton had an equivalent kinetic energy of a tennis ball traveling at more than 100 kilometers an hour. All that energy from a single proton. If this tennis ball were to travel at that speed, the amount of kinetic energy that it would carry would be equivalent to 42 million times that of the biggest nuclear bomb ever detonated. And as you maybe know, that bomb was 10 times more powerful than all of the explosives used in World War II. Or, this ball traveling at that speed would be about 10 times more powerful than a 10-kilometer asteroid that made dinosaurs go extinct. Imagine how powerful that would be. The question we have right now is, where do they come from and how come they have so much energy? And the answer is that we don't really know. We have some theories that they come from supernovas, but that's much more difficult to prove than it seems. For example, if you detect gamma ray bursts, all you have to do is to look up, see a supernova, and your job is done. But cosmic rays come from everywhere, so you can't know where they come from. Since their path is influenced by magnetic fields from the stars and the galaxy, they don't go in a straight line throughout the universe. That's why pinpointing their origin is really hard. But it isn't that hard to detect them. We can do it without using any special equipment at all. But I'll have to leave that for the next video. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.